Jordan Staal waved out of the face-off circle. Brock McGinn takes it, but the draw is won by Patrice Bergeron. And away comes the Boston Bruins, gaining the Canes end with Story Krug. Lays it off for Charlie Coyle, who flips it behind the Canes net. Joel Edmondson bangs it around the point. Now Brock McGinn intercepts. He's in on a break on Rask. Short-handed. McGinn backhand. He scores! What a move by Brock McGinn! It's a shorty, and the Canes have tied it at two.
Sponsored by Poetic Justice for Brock McGinn and the Canes. The Game 7 hero in overtime against Washington. Pressure, anticipating the D-to-D pass. Oh, did he ever get Rask to bite? Wow! Good for Jordan Staal, pressuring the way that McGinn and Staal have always read off of each other, shorthanded. Oh, baby, that is the definition through and through of Poetic Justice.
A huge momentum shift, but the Canes still have a power play that they have to kill off as the Bruins attack. Now comes back in with a minute 25 on the man advantage, but the Canes get to the puck on the far boards and flip it back in on Tuukka Rask. The first goal of the postseason for Brock McGinn. He's got a knack for big goals. Now the Boston Bruins throw it in off of the backboards, but it's going to be icing as they threw it in from beyond center ice.
Here's a hurricane right here. He was as the captain and now as the coach. Let's just watch it. You bet, Rod. Those boys will run through a rampart, a wall, a moat. They don't run through a moat, but they'll do anything for that guy.
I think for this guy, they could run through a moat. I'm just saying.
Yeah, he'd hang out on Tom Hanks' Castaway Island for about three decades for Rod Brind'Amour.